Bangers, I'm only dropping in for a bit. I've still got a long way to go. It's a bit complicated. I've kind of avenged Alistair's death, but I kind of haven't.
It's okay. We're being guards until you come back. By the time you get back properly, me and Mash will be the best guards ever.
Thank you.
Jessica!
So it's a bit com...
By the time you get back...
When did you get back? Just now, but I've got to leave again straight away. I still haven't dealt with the person responsible for Alistair's death. I'm sorry.
No. That's all right.
You do what you have to do. Just make sure you come back when it's all taken care of.
Thank you.
It's almost too cold to bear. But if we don't retrieve the scepter, Medea and I may never return to normal. We'll just have to grin and bear it. Let's keep pushing on. At least moving might help us to warm up a little. I shouldn't have to put up with being in a freezing place like this. It's all Magus's fault. Well, but he's dead now. So I suppose it's that Leo what's-his-name's fault. I don't know. A dog of all things. Oh,
I'll stop your whinging, Grandad. It ain't as if we've got a sweat on, you know. Just get on with it.
I beg your pardon? How uncalled for! I don't see why I shouldn't be able to say whatever I please. You've no right to talk to me like that. No right at all. I'm absolutely... Livid, I tell you. I'm going on ahead.
Thank you. That dog over there's called Boris. He's the one who dug us out from the snow. What a dog. He's a lot more use than a certain king, don't you think? And he smells a bit better, too.
I heard that, Angelo. More use than a certain king, you say? How dare you? Honestly, who do you think called for the dog's help in the first place?
That dog over there's called... What a dog. He's a lot...
How dare you, boy! How could you say such a thing about your own master? Honestly, who do you think called for the dog's help in the first place?
Drink. This nook grass tea will keep you warm even in the bitter cold of this snowy land.
How terribly kind of you. First you save us from the avalanche, then you put us up for the night, and now you warm our innards. Now that's what I call hospitality.
And what's really amazing is that you helped a weird old monster like him in the first place.
You loathsome lowlife! You, of all people, have no right to call me weird!
It is true that his appearance is a little unusual. But when you get to my age, you'll learn not to judge a horse by its harness. And of course, I would help anyone who was in trouble so far from civilization.
I hope you don't mind me asking, but why do you live all the way out here on your own?
Of course I do not mind, dear. There is an old ruin behind my house. My ancestors have looked after it generation after generation. It is a family duty. But that will all end with me. I have no one to follow in my footsteps when my life is finished.
Really? It must be pretty tough living on your own like this. Duty or no duty?
It is comfortable enough. I have lived here since I was a child, so it is not a hardship. Besides, to live life is not to walk through a meadow. And from time to time, people get lost here in the mountains like you, so I am not lonely. And I always have Boris to keep me company.
Ah, on the subject of dogs, we had something to ask you, Marta. This will sound a bit strange, But we're pursuing a big black dog, and we heard that he might have been headed in this direction. There's a good chance he may have come this way. Have you seen anything?
No. I am sorry. The only dog I know about is big old Boris over there. Sorry I cannot be of more help. You should ask where there is a lot of people. If you go down the mountain and go to the north, you will come to a town called Orkutsk. Maybe someone will know something there.
Ah, that sounds like an excellent idea. Right then, chaps, there's no time to lose.
Oh, yo-yo, if you are hasty, others will only be amused. That is an old saying here. One should not be so eager to go back out into the blizzard. The night is coming. Why don't you rest here? I am sure the blizzard will be gone by morning, so you can leave for Orkutsk then.
Yes, yes. Wise words, my good woman. Very well, we shall rest here for the night.
Go north from the bottom of the mountain, and you will come to Orkutsk. Please be careful on your journey.
By George! Princess! Are you all right? Were you cold in the night?
Forgive me, but I must ask you a favor. If you meet with a man called Marek in Orkutsk, please give this to him. He is probably working with herbs like I am. I would be grateful if you could give him that bag. Spasibo. Thank you.
Right then! Off to Orkutsk! Toodly bye!
Yeah.
have some good news. I've just turned 18. How about that? I had grass instead of birthday cake, though. I remember the first time you came to the castle. We were just 8 years old. It's hard to believe we've known each other for 10 years now. You were an orphan, so you lived in the castle. And in what seemed like no time, you worked your way up to palace guard. Actually, I have a secret. I recommended you for the position to my father. It was a way to bring you closer to me, so we could spend more time together. And anyway, you deserved it. So, my brave palace guardsman, I'm counting on you to make sure I spend my next birthday as a human. I know you can do it.
Thank you.
It seems we've arrived in Orkutsk at last. And that nook grass really is quite marvellous. I wasn't a bit cold, even in all that snow. Now, we can stay outdoors as long as we like. Excellent! Well, I'll be waiting outside the town as usual. In you go!
Dear sister, you look so beautiful when you pray. Too beautiful. Dear goddess, what should a poor soul such as I do, now I have fallen for one of your flock?
Confess. Even when you are racked with self-doubt, have faith in her divine benevolence. The goddess looks kindly upon those who take action.
Was that an angel? Oh, I understand. I will do exactly as you say.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome to Dreamland, Sleepyhead. I'm so grateful for these chances to talk to you. And I'm so happy Jessica's back with us. Even if Father and I are still cursed. Sometimes I wonder if we'll have to spend the rest of our lives like this. I'm sorry. It's just that I get so sad every time I think of Trodane covered in thorns. You know what's strange, though? That you weren't affected by the curse. But I shouldn't be surprised. I always knew there was something special about you. Don't forget to take me to the spring every now and then. I miss talking to you.
Thank you.
I'm sorry. Give me a minute. I spend my days thinking about what I should talk to you about the next time we come to the spring. But there are so many things to share. Sometimes I just don't know where to start. Traveling together is so much fun. But it would be even better if I weren't a horse.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
anybody there? Help me! I am too cold! I cannot move! Help! Gathering herbs here in this cave when suddenly some wolves attacked me. I panicked and ran deep inside. Then I got trapped by the falling icicles and could not get out. I am so cold. I have to find a way to warm up. What is that bug you have?
Did you get it from an old babushka called Marta? So, she asked you to bring it to me. Can you open the bag for me? I knew it! Dobroy! This will be perfect! Normally, we drink this diluted in tea, but now I must take it straight. Grass must always be diluted. At least it was not the powdered form. No one wants that up their nose. Anyway, now I am warm, that is for sure. Thank you. You have saved me, my friends. And she saved me too. Now I believe her old saying that there is no bad without good. But how could she have known this would happen? If you are going back to Orkutsk, perhaps we could travel together. Thank you. I am very grateful. If the wolves attack again, we are better to have safety in numbers.
Have they been waiting for me? There are so many of them. Be careful. These are no normal wolves. Ha! Help me, friends! Why do they come for me like this?
Wait! He is not the one. I sense Sage's blood, but it is not him. There must be another. We must find the chosen heir of the Sage.
What was that voice? And what does it mean by the chosen heir? I cannot understand. It cannot be real.
Thank you.
First, I must tell you about Marta. I did not mean to hide it. There was just no time to tell you before. She is my mother. I should be the one to take over from her. I should look after the ruin behind the house when she is gone. So, I suppose you wonder why I am living here. The truth is, I abandoned my home. And my mother, too. She is a wise woman. I wanted to put all I had learned from her to good use. But I could not do that if I stayed in the mountains. So I made my decision to leave, and I came here to help the people of Orkutsk with my herbs. And I should be happy, because I have helped them very much. But still, I am guilty for leaving my mother all alone. Then, today, you appear with a bag of herbs she sent to me. I cannot tell you how happy I am. It makes me feel that she has finally accepted the choice I made.
That's what parents are for. We always try to take care of our children and help them out if they're in a pickle. But I'm sure you didn't invite us here to tell us your life story. If I'm not mistaken, you have a favor to ask.
Forgive me, you are right. There is something that is worrying me about my mother. You heard it too, that strange voice when the wolves tried to attack me. It said something about me having the blood of a sage. But that I was not the one, that it must find the chosen heir. Well, an ancestor of mine was a sage, one of the sages that sealed away the Lord of Darkness. Now my mother and I are the only ones left from this bloodline. So, if I am not the heir, I am worried for her safety. So, I have decided to visit her and see that she is all right. And this is where I must ask you a favor. Will you come with me? I am a little uneasy about going alone. You will? Спасибо! Then we must hurry. We should leave at once.
Excuse me, Dr. Marek, but there is a patient here to see you. It is madness, drinking yourself into a stupor and passing out in the snow dressed like that. Of course you catch a cold.
Sorry, but I am in a hurry.
I feel terrible. So dizzy. Oh, I'm dying. I'm dying!
All right, I will see you. I have just gathered some herbs that will cure you quickly. I have no choice. Forgive me, but I must stay here for now. I will come after you as soon as I can. Will you go on ahead to my mother's house? I hope that there will be no problem, but please, go and see that she is all right.